And some cricket news now. India's women's team captain, Harmanpreet Kaur, is in the spotlight. I'm afraid not for the right reasons. Her actions in Bangladesh have triggered an online debate. She's also been suspended by the ICC, that's the International Cricket Council. Harmanpreet will now miss two international matches, plus a 50% match fee fine. But what exactly did she do? Let me tell you the backstory. Team India had travelled to Bangladesh for a series. We played three one-day internationals. Bangladesh won the first, India won the second, and the third was tied. But Harmanpreet was not happy. India was on course to win the third match, but towards the end, we lost a cluster of wickets. And one of those wickets was Harmanpreet. She was given leg before wicket, LBW, by the umpire. Harmanpreet disagreed with that decision. She smashed the stumps in disgust. That was strike one. Strike two came during the post-match presentation. Harmanpreet called the standard of umpiring pathetic. She also passed a sarcastic jibe while receiving the trophy. Harmanpreet said, "The umpires tied the match for you, so call them for the photo as well." No point arguing about it. It was a low blow, what she said and what she did. But the internet is divided. One side is supporting Harmanpreet's actions. They say it's all about passion and aggression. The other side disagrees. They say it sends a bad message to viewers, especially to young kids. Women's cricket is making giant strides right now. It's an inspiration for young girls and boys around the world. Would you want them to see such behavior? I'm guessing not. At the same time, it's hard to ignore the double standards here. Commentators have different yardsticks for men and women. Male athletes are expected to be aggressive. And female athletes? Well, not so much. When they display emotions or aggression, it's frowned upon. Serena Williams experienced it multiple times. She's been called intimidating and manly. She's also been compared to animals. Same with Martina Navratilova, another tennis icon. Look at how this website described her. A gal with manly arms. And it's not just about aggression. Any emotion displayed by female athletes is put under a microscope. Meet Gabby Douglas. She's a gymnast from the United States. Guess what she was criticized for? Not cheering hard enough for her teammates. Another example is Lisa Leslie. She used to play in the women's NBA. Commentators found her, quote unquote, difficult. And why is that? Because apparently she was aloof and self-absorbed. Now compare this to how male athletes are treated. Their aggression is not criticized. In fact, it is celebrated. Take Virat Kohli, for example. In his early days, Kohli was famous for his on-field antics. He once showed a middle finger to the crowd in Australia. He has, in fact, abused multiple times on the field. But what does the media call him? The face of New India. Surely this is a double standard, and we are not defending what Harmanpreet Kaur did. She was captaining Team India. It's an honor that very few people get. She should have handled the situation better, maybe waited until after the presentation, or used better words. At the same time, we must criticize this online hypocrisy. You can't have different standards for male and female athletes. What's wrong is wrong. Harmanpreet's predecessor summed it up best. Her name is Mithali Raj. She wrote an article about this entire incident. Listen to what she said. It's okay to be aggressive and show emotions to a point. But one shouldn't forget the game is above individuals. While Harman's anguish is understandable, her behavior shouldn't be condoned. You can't play sports without passion, maybe even aggression. But aggression doesn't mean insulting your opponents or lashing out at umpires. It can be controlled, directed, and effective.